Well, looks like I've got everything I need ready to safely use the negative singularity. And with the place overrun with cows, the dark elf bear naga on the loose, and my cheetah supply completely exhausted, I don't see any reason to stay here much longer. Funny. I never thought I'd miss this place. Well, here goes nothing.
Here I am, though I wish I was braver. We all came here today for a last group.
In the last episode of The Brave New World, I was visited by strange, misshapen cow things. In today's episode, I am reunited with an old friend. I'm Renegade X, and this is my show. Hello, random people from across the internet. I'm Renegade X, and welcome to the show sponsored by the bloody heck? What was that? I heard an explosion noise. Oh, lovely. It appears we have an alien visitor from the future. Maybe, possibly. Ed, is that you?
I'm pretty sure it is.
Ed, it's been so long, buddy. What are you doing here?
I'm standing.
Yes, you are. How did you get here?
Same way you did.
You pulled a lever and pushed a button on a rock that had a button and a lever on it?
No, I used a negative singularity that used to be in the rock, but then it kind of ate it.
What do you mean, ate it?
Well, you know how it used to contain the negative singularity?
Yeah.
Well, when you pushed the lever and pulled the button, it stopped doing that.
I thought I pushed the button and then pulled the lever.
Well, whatever you did, it got destabilized, and now I had to stabilize it using the power of love.
Ed, how did you use the power of love? There's no one else around except for the cows. Ed, you didn't.
Yep.
Oh, unbelievable! I was gonna save that wheat for bread.
Well, it's not like you're gonna need it now. The entire place is a wasteland, completely devoid of any habitable life, unsustainable in every single way.
You ran out of Cheetos, didn't you?
Completely out.
Well, I guess as long as you're here, want me to get you something to eat?
No, thanks. I think I'll just stand here.
Okay. Ed, I can't help but notice your leg seems to be, on backwards.
Yeah, don't worry about it. I'll fix that later.
Ed, Nate, what? You know what? Sure. I'll let you do that. Meantime, I'm gonna get to build. Mind if I just build around you?
No, go ahead.
Thanks. Alright, so good to have Ed back.
I love you too.
Good to know, Ed! I have got to be quieter when I talk about him. So let's see, do I have any more rocks? Let's see, there's you, and do I have more coal? I do have these. Man, I've really got to get my inventory organized.
No kidding!
How on earth can you hear me?
Magic.
Yes, but what type of magic?
Really good magic.
Ask a vague question, I suppose.
It wasn't vague, I just feel like messing with you.
Good to know, Ed. Good to know. Ah, lovely. Ed, can you hear me?
What? Did you say something?
Never mind, I'll ask him when I get back there. You know, a thought occurs to me. Whenever there's... The last time Ed played around with genetics, we wound up with a giant, snake thing. And now I'm noticing a bunch of random, unnatural cow hybrid things. So, I'm just wondering... Wait, what? What the heck is this stuff? What is this? Ender chests? That's very bizarre. Hopefully I can cut that out. Ed. I have a question for you.
Yeah?
First of all, what are the ender chests that are out there for?
I wouldn't touch those. They may contain radioactive material.
Good to know. Second, Ed, how did you know for certain that the negative singularity wouldn't warp you beyond compare?
I didn't. That's why I chucked a bunch of cows as test subjects in there.
I see.
By the way, did you ever figure out where they ended up?
Yes, they did. I figured out where they ended up, Ed, and, the answer is, down there.
Down in your floor?
Well, there's a cave there, and I put a little, I made a little pen for them so they can't get out. It's... Honestly, Ed, I think we need to have a talk about your dimensional experiments.
Is this the same talk we had about the birds and the bees?
Yes, it's the exact same talk, Ed. Except completely different because we're not crossing bird DNA with bee DNA.
Bee DNA. That sounds like a very strange kink.
And we're done. So... With all of that said, and my brain thoroughly deprocessing everything Ed is doing with his life, and possibly my own, I'm gonna start ahead with the montage. Bye-bye, y'all. Or, not... Cue montage.
Brothers of the mind, rejoice.
Sing, sing, sing with me.
Raise your pick and raise your voice.
Sing, sing, sing with me.
Down and down into the deep. Who knows what we'll find beneath. Diamonds, rubies, gold and more, hidden in the mountain shore. Born underground, suckled from a teeth of snow, raised in the dark, the safety of a mountain home. Skin made of iron, steel in our bones. To dig and dig makes us free. Come on, brother, sing with me.
Ed, it's getting pretty late outside. Do you want to come in?
No thanks, monsters won't eat me.
How do you know this, exactly?
Well, they've tried. Turns out they're, me intolerant.
What did you do to yourself?
I may have coated myself with anti-monster pheromones, max repels, and or, bacon.
Like, fresh bacon?
No, raw bacon. That's been sitting out for weeks on end.
You'd think that would attract them more.
It does not. It actually makes them very repulsed. And I was talking to you.
Sorry, Ed. Look, I get it, you're mad. I'll just back away.
No, don't. Look, Ren. I know we haven't been on the best of terms always, but I just want you to know you really are my friend, and I did want to come see you specifically.
Aw, thanks, Ed.
Now go to sleep before monsters eat your brains out.
It's only gonna be an hors d'oeuvre. Good night, Ed. Love you too, bud. That was a great night's sleep. What do you think, Ed?
I don't know. I wasn't watching. I was busy staring at this wall all night. The architecture here is fascinating.
Thank you. I literally just slapped a bunch of bricks together.
Well, you better get back to it then.
I will. Re-engage montage?
Re-engage montage.
Re-engage montage!
I am a dwarf and I'm digging a hole. Diggy diggy hole, diggy
diggy hole. I am a dwarf and I'm digging a hole. Diggy diggy hole, digging a hole. Alright, Ed, so I think I've cleared out enough for one day.
Alright, I guess that's fair. Wait, what?
Oh, Ed, I want to show you something really cool with this Dominomicon. Let's see, what is it? Okay, yeah. Okay, so Ed, you know how usually it takes a while for me to scan things?
Uh-huh.
Well, boom, check this out!
Ooh, looks like magic operates differently in this dimension.
Yeah, and apparently I never scanned grass.
Some things never change.
Say, would you like to take a look at this you want to take a look at the magic book and see how magic works here?
Sure. As soon as you figure out how to pronounce it.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Alright, I'm done.
What, already?
Yeah, I took a speed reading course. Took forever to get me through it, though, but once I did.
Huh, neat. Wonder if you can... Oh, by the way, I made this book earlier.
Oh, what's it about?
Well, just take a look and see.
Huh, that's odd. This is oddly coherent.
Hey, I can write coherent things.
Ooh, there's sirens, aren't there?
I think? Let me check. There's no sirens in here. Ed, did you read a page that I haven't unlocked yet?
It's possible. I do have absolutely no respect for your fourth wall.
Ed, come on. I really worked hard to build that. Oh, speaking of walls, I'm just going to head outside and see what I can build.
All right, have fun with that.
Wait, can I make graywack rocks? Or bricks, I mean? Wait, what can I use these for? Crafting. Looking for bricks. New.
Large bloodstone tile. Ew. What's that about bloodstones?
Never mind, Dad. Just keep staring at your wall.
Will do.
No. What's this? Corrosive stone. Probably not a good idea. Raw stone. Probably should cook that. Steadfast stone. Stone brick path. Imperfect ritual stone. Tiny planet. Unusual. What the heck is a tiny planet? Wonder what it does. Stone of temperance. Spiral stone bricks. Stone rod. Arcane base. Whatever the heck this is. Growth accelerator. Okay. Tool masher. That's probably not. Are any of these actual bricks or... Okay. Make a sturdy stone, a stone table. Another sturdy stone. How many sturdy stones does one dimension need? Yeah, well, looks like I ain't making bricks out of this. That is the moral I'm getting from this story. Speaking of which, I'll chuck you in there, and then you there, and then... I really do need to organize this stuff at some point. Maybe off screen later. Maybe I should make another door. Do I have any more wood? Wood. Nope. Wood. I have you, but I don't have any more. Darn it!
Did you forget to make wood again?
Oh, shush you.
I can't. It's literally in my nature to be as unhelpful as possible.
Well, that explains a couple things, don't it?
It might, but then again, it might not.
Why can't I make great wood doors anymore? Wait, what? Did it just... Okay, never mind then.
Renegade, I really need to hook up that fiber optic telepathic thing that I was inventing so that we can Skype chat across multiple distances.
Multiple distances? Ed, the way you put that makes it sound like I'll be in two places at once.
Give me time.
And like that, I'm gone.
Wait, come back. Well, this is awkward.
Indeed it is. I'm just gonna scout out a couple things here.
Don't mind me, I'll just be sitting here awkwardly.
No, you'll be standing there awkwardly.
That as well, too, yes.
Alright, so I'm thinking...
That's dangerous.
Indeed. So let's see if I can maybe... I like the way this is shaping up, but I'm starting to wonder if maybe, just maybe, I should make this like an... Like, this sort of area is like an open courtyard.
Oh, you mean kind of like your old place?
Yes, except much bigger and with bigger towers in here.
Oh. So then this would be like kind of an entrance room?
I guess so.
Huh. I think I like where you're going.
Thanks, Ed!
Yeah, no problem. Just remember...
Just remember what?
I forgot.
Oh well. You know, it's amazing how we can talk to each other through walls.
Yes, it's almost as if one of us is voiced by the exact same person as the other.
Ed?
Fine, I'll leave your fourth wall alone.
You know, I feel like you're pestering this wall over here.
Is it the fourth wall?
No.
Then I'm not doing any harm, am I?
Point taken. Man.
Whew.
Should probably do something with this milk parrot? Good heavens. There is so much wrong with that thing. A lot to unpack with that, but we're just gonna throw away the entire suitcase. Alright, okay, I now have obtained a lot of saplings. Okay, I thought that was some sort of horrible creature, but no, it's a bunch of horrible creatures. All just coexisting in the same general space. Just, you know, asking themselves, why? Why? Why am I like this? You know, another thought occurs, but I'll ask Ed later. I'll let him rest while he's standing up like a horse. Because that's what friends do. Friends let their friends rest by standing up like horses. I don't know. I think I just figured out why I don't have many friends. Alright, so... oh, wait. Before I do anything with this, I'll want to take you out. There, and just replace you with, what the heck. What the heck, I can spare one. And then go like... No! That is not the block I meant to place. I meant to place this one. Thank goodness. Alright. So, now I still gotta dig this out, don't I? Power build? Or I mean, power dig. Initiate! Ah, I love the power of editing. Almost better than Thaumcraft. Almost. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I could just put one in there and... Alright, we are good to go. What are... Okay. Over here now, I suppose. And there we go. Yep, now everything is nice and the way it should be. Mutant cow creatures notwithstanding, obviously, but, let's see. Should I? Maybe. Why don't I? What's the worst that could happen? I probably shouldn't have said that. Oh, right. So, I think that's gonna have to do it, ladies and gentlemen. If you did enjoy, please be sure to give a like, a comment, a subscribe, and whatever. And, before I sign off officially, Ed, I remember what I was gonna ask you earlier. You are positive nothing followed you, right? Because last I checked, there was a pretty nasty monster on the other side of the singularity where you were from. Ed? I'm thinking... should be fine. I mean, come on, Renegade. Do you really think I'd be so irresponsible as to let a giant monster in follow me through a portal? Kind of. Well, let me reassure you. The only thing keeping that portal stable was a constant stream of love from those cows breeding. Now that I'm not there to keep that cycle going, the singularity will either collapse in on itself or destroy the entire dimension it's located in.
That is not the most comforting thing you've said to me, Ed.
Think about it like this. It took me weeks to figure out how to get the portal to leave where I wanted it to, and even more time to make sure I arrived in one piece. I've run the numbers, Renegade. There's no way Elfinion will be able to follow us. Trust me.